that when it comes to that area of aspect, you must bring your wife to a level that she commands you. When it comes to sexual intercourse, you listen to your wife.
She is in charge.
She is in charge. She directs you. Some men don't need to be directed. She tell you how to do it. She tell you, oh, touch here, go here. Sometimes if she felt that you are not hearing what she's saying, she use her own hand to pick your hand and put it where she wants you to be. But some men will not like, you say, I want to stay here. You don't need to stay there.
The woman is in charge.
The woman is in charge. Because she needs it most. When you enter 5 minutes, you have gone. And that's why whether you are a 5 seconds man or it doesn't count. When that foreplay is there, you take the woman to where she belongs. And it's a taboo for a man to just release without the consent of the woman. That is where this communication matters in marriage, everything. When it comes to this sexual aspect, one need to communicate. You know this mentality of Africa, man, is contrary to the Bible. God does not support it. There is no superiority at all. This is not the way you need it. This is not how each of you
just have to balance
that. This is how I need it. So for a woman to always be making it available for the man is not enough.
No, it's not enough.
You must do what is needed. There must be foreplay. You must know. Those are why what other side she does. And you know some men who are so addicted to pornographic films. They want their wife to be doing what those
what
people
saying.
And without knowing, those people does it to be paid.
Exactly.
And who will pay your wife? Because it is not just sleeping with a woman to get satisfaction. The romancing aspect should take a longer period. Because why? The woman needs it more. She needs to be touched. Some women, like she said, are not sex drive. From the where we came from, circumcision is one of the major killers of sexual health. That is why our women don't easily move. And some men want them to move, they don't move. And we need to push. When the car doesn't move, we push. So it's a battery that is going to push. It will get. So what? How do you push? Start with pushing. Start with a little, drinking, touching, and other things. Sometimes she may not even tell her, okay, like that, let me massage your body. You are poking her, you are pulling her. And you know, sometimes there's what they call a woman at time of heat period. They need that when the body makes it. It makes the things also available. So that is why the Bible now, when that comes to the center of the Bible, that says defraud not one another.
Of it.
The man, whenever the woman needs it, the man should not say, I'm tired. Because you are like a soldier. The moment you sign to go to war, even when you are talking of a woman, when they call you, you must not finish what you are doing. You must jump up and get ready to war. So the same thing, when the Bible says the man should render to the woman, and both of them should not
defraud each other,
they should not stay longer. Even when they want to engage in fasting, it will be consent that I will be fasting. You cannot just wake up as a man and say, God is leading me to 3 days fasting. Your second God must answer it or yes or no. Because in marriage, God has given autonomy to the couple. That is why he said when a wife vowed in the church and the husband is not there and he came to tell the husband, I vow 200 euro today. And the man said, I didn't sign it. God said that vow is cancelled. So he has given autonomy to the couple. And when it comes to sexual intercourse, he has also given equal rights. There is no seniority. There is no minority that I'm the man, I'm the
man.
Everyone is equal. Just as the woman has the authority, this is your pen. You lend me your pen. If you need your pen, will you be begging me for your pen? I need my pen. I should be the one to tell you, I'm tired. I'm this. Can we? Postponing, can we do this? Can we? There must be bargaining.
Exactly.
There must be something to be done. Like Mama said, when a woman really gets satisfied, there's nothing that happened to her outside. She knows what she's getting inside.
This is for Luke. This question is for you. Lack of affection in marriage. Can it lead to divorce? Because from what she said on her previous video, she said, there are some men, they said their wife is not that attractive. suddenly?
Like me, I like to talk from the point of view, from the general point of view.
Mm.
I mean, I don't like to limit myself only to the Bible. I'm also a Christian, but exactly. I don't limit myself because we have other views.
Mm-hmm.
I can say that lack of affection might lead to divorce in marriage. It might lead and it might not lead. Depending,
you can rectify it.
Depending on the parties and depending on how early it has been detected. Like, you can't say a woman will be in a house or a man will be in a house for like 2 years, 3 years. And lack of affection that you are talking about, I think it also involves sex.
Exactly.
You cannot say a man or a woman will be in a house 2 years, 3 years, the man will not touch her, and you expect her to stay in the marriage. For me, it's a no. Because you can't be in a environment where two of you are not compatible,
mm-hmm.
there is no love, there is no sex, and you are staying there for what purpose?
For what purpose?
Even, but as long as you two of you have seen each other, there might even be hatred that one person will kill the other person.
Mm-hmm.
So it's better everybody
step aside.
Or if it can be solved, if there can be remedy, they can make approach. But there are some cases that for some people it's so
mm-hmm.
hard.
It's
no
so
matter
hard.
How they try.
Try.
It's all
they don't have to no pathways.
There can't be a solution. Maybe because they had a wrong foundation.
Foundation.
Maybe they had the wrong foundation. Maybe the marriage was based on lies, on some other things. Or some people see all this popular thing they are using for people now. Mama, these things the girls in Lagos are buying for men now. They used to call it Kayamata or something.
Mm.
For example, a girl uses Kayamata on a man, and the man falls in love with the girl, and later on the kayamata expires, and you expect that kind of relationship that there should be affection.
No.
Since the kayamata has expired, definitely the man's eyes will be clear. Or the woman's eyes will be clear. How am I even in this marriage for God's sake? So that kind of marriage, you cannot encourage them to stay inside. If not, one person will kill the other person. So it depends for me. It depends. Lack of affection, it can lead to divorce, and it depends. It might not lead to it if it can be corrected.
If it
can be corrected, that's what I said.
But when it comes to normal sex, we talk about in marriage.
Okay.
It's a glue.